love him or hate him. Team Messiah or team Antichrist. There is no one in the world like Donald Trump. Yet Trump's role in our world, it extends far beyond what we are fed on TV screens and social media feeds. In fact, no one occupies a more prominent role in the shady recesses of the conspiratorial underworld than the self-proclaimed chosen one. Which Trump conspiracies have you heard of? How about The Adventures of Baron Trump, the book series written at the end of the 19th century, the book series that concluded with The Last President, a prophetic foretelling of the election of a New York outsider who would bring America to its knees? How about Trump as the time traveller, his family links to Nikola Tesla through his uncle John, and, of course, the memorialization of this conspiracy in Biff from Back to the Future? Speaking of time travel, how about Donnie Darko? You know, the troubled child who goes back in time to sacrifice himself for the one he loves. Was it a bit too obvious that the character of the title was another ode to another famous Donnie? One whose role in this realm continues to take an increasingly darker, even sacrificial tone. So where else does Donnie Darko lead us? How about coronas or eclipses? Funnily enough, given how popular they have both suddenly become. But also, if we dig a little bit deeper, to the moon itself. And it is here that we arrive at the bottom of the Donald Trump rabbit hole with the conspiracy of the moon child. What is the moon child? And what might it have to do with the chosen one? Well, maybe we should ask Aleister Crowley. Occultist, sex magician, and, among other things, founder of the secret society Thelema. Crowley seeded the concept of the moon child with his 1917 novel of the same name. It depicted the birth of a child through ritualistic dark magic, an antichrist figure, the biblical beast whose destiny it would be to bring the world to the brink of destruction in order to usher in a new age. A new age Crowley called the Aeon of Horus. Or maybe we can ask L. Ron Hubbard, a Crowley acolyte who would later create the science fiction religion of Scientology, based around, it is said, the occult rituals of Thelema. Or, even better, can we ask Jack Parsons, perhaps the most famous rocket scientist of all time, who joined Hubbard in the most famous of these rituals, the Babylon working? Unfortunately, we can't ask Jack. He was mysteriously killed in an explosion in 1952. They actually made a TV show about Parsons called Strange Angel, which was released, interestingly enough, on June 14th, 2018. Just a coincidence that a certain prophetic figure was also born on this date, and on a blood moon eclipse. The setting for episode 1 of Strange Angel. Also, interestingly enough, it was 1946, only a few months beforehand, when Parsons and Hubbard conducted their Moonchild summoning rituals. Here's another question. Why did Crowley call his prophetic character the Moonchild? Well, along with everything else, Crowley was also an astrologer. If astrology is real, and Crowley certainly thought so, presumably there would be something significant astrologically, something about the moon, something uniquely lunar woven into the moon child story, like perhaps a blood moon, total lunar eclipse. In fact, if we look just a little deeper at the astrology of June 14, 1946, we can see quite clearly that this was no normal total lunar eclipse. In fact, if we were to think just a little conspiratorially, we might look upon the timing of Donald Trump's birth, much like his life, has been somewhat suspiciously scripted, perhaps even right down to the minute of his birth. Welcome to the astrology of the Moon Child.